It is no secret that we live in a culture that is driven by an insatiable desire to consume, an unwavering thirst to buy as many things, own as many houses, own as many cars as we possibly can. And what is most ironic about this consumer-driven culture is that even when we get exactly what we think we want, it is never enough. As the great Stoic philosopher Epictetus once stated, enough will never be enough for whom enough is too little. Over the course of my life, I have owned many things. When I was younger, we couldn't afford much, but we had everything that we needed. Now as I'm older, and I've dived deeper into the realm of minimalism and detachment from owning things, I can confidently say that it's become a way of life that I will stick with for the rest of my time here on Earth. Everything that I own fits in the bed of my truck, and that's not an exaggeration. Through this process of minimalizing my possessions, I've grown a deep appreciation for what I have and an immense amount of gratitude for the things that I have. It's allowed me to view the world through a different way, and through the discomfort of owning less, it's allowed me to have gratitude for the times in my life where I am allotted comfort. And through the discomfort of owning less and the straying away of owning material possessions, I have successfully been able to declutter my brain and have a clean, organized space wherever I go, whoever I'm with, and wherever I'm living. In addition to the immense gratitude that came from minimizing my material possessions, I also experienced what true detachment is. Detachment is an idea stemming from Buddhist philosophy, containing the basic precept that it's not necessarily about owning nothing, but nothing owning you. For me, at the height of owning as many things as I once had, I found myself becoming more overwhelmed by the clutter than I did the enjoyment in having the things to begin with. And of course, there's that initial fear when you first get rid of something that seems sentimental, but I would say a vast majority of the time, when I rid myself of things that I do not use, that do not serve me, and that I have no need for anymore, the liberation I find through the detachment is overwhelmingly powerful at organizing my subconscious and my life. And if I needed to move or needed to go somewhere else, I was liberated from the weight of those things. This idea of detachment can create a true sense of liberation and separation from the consumer-driven culture that we all are indoctrinated by from such a young age. We are not our things. We are not our possessions. And no amount of money or things will ever fill that void in us that creeps up in the absence of stimulation. Think about it. How many times have you been bored, or you're going through a hard time, or you're having a hard day, and you find yourself aimlessly browsing on Amazon or going to the mall, only to purchase something that gives you a momentary sense of dopaminergic energy, and then later leaves you feeling guilty for having spent the money on a thing that you don't really need? And to make something clear, I think it's important to own things that serve you a purpose and that you put to use. Even the spaces within your home, creating rooms that have a specific purpose for yoga, for meditations, for music, for creation, allowing yourself to organize your mind and your space in a way that allows your subconscious to have a more linear approach to living your life. Another powerful tool that I found effective for owning nothing and practicing detachment is the act of taking a photo of something. I would wager that some of you watching this have a box full of things, or several boxes full of things, or nostalgic possessions that you hold on to because they mean something to you. And while I understand the sentiment and it's admirable that you hold on to it all of these years, what if that material possession could be serving somebody else? Especially if you're not looking at it every day or using it every day, it most likely could be put to better use by donating it or gifting it to somebody. We have these amazing tools on our cell phones. You use a Polaroid camera and take a photo. Typically, when you want to revisit nostalgia, you want to just look at the thing, and it brings up that sense of a memory. So by taking a photo of it and saving it in your phone, you're not only getting the same somatic experience, but you're also simultaneously minimizing your possessions and liberating you from the oftentimes burdensome worry of having to own and possess. Many of the friends and family that I have looked at the way that I live my life with critical lies. And that's understandable, as most of us, again, are indoctrinated with these ideologies of owning things since we're very young. Our culture perpetuates the idea that in order for you to be successful, the more you own, the happier you are. And this reminds me of an idea that I explored back in grad school, this idea of there being a truth and a lie. The truth is that if you're stranded out in the middle of the desert with no food and no water, and you have no idea what to do, and then all of a sudden somebody comes along, picks you up in an air-conditioned vehicle, gives you a gallon of water, a cool towel to put around your face, and takes you to a cabin where you take a shower, relax, and have a good night's sleep. You immediately go from being unhappy to very happy in a very short period of time. And it was the things that made the difference. Now, the lie is, well, if this amount of stuff made me this happy, then 2 times the amount of stuff will make me 2 times happier. 10 times happier. You get the idea. It is not the quantity of the material possessions you own, it is the quality. And when people who practice minimalism and detachment say they own nothing, it doesn't actually mean they own nothing. They just don't own the nothingness found in excess. This is where the idea of less is more is substantiated and factual. Through learning to let go of the burdens and stressors that come from overconsumption, learn how to relish in the gratitude of owning nothing. Let's quickly get into the sponsor of today's video, Liquid IV. Liquid IV is a staple in the hydration and fitness industry, specializing in electrolyte hydration and additives to tap water to make a single glass of water act like drinking 3 glasses of water. With many different flavors to choose from and a variety of different products, including the energy multiplier, Liquid IV has become daily use for me, and I recommend it to anybody who struggles to consume enough water and hydrate the vehicle body that all of us push to a limit on a daily basis. To try Liquid IV now, visit liquid-iv.com and use promo code CaseyRyanMusic for 20% off. The link will be in the description below.